Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping you with the architecture of WAP, or you can say wireless access protocol. So let's start. So the architecture is not at all complex. The only thing is you need to know it very nicely, and if you know it very nicely, this won't be a problem for you. And if you talk about WAP, WAP is the basic for internet in mobile. So it is very important for subjects like mobile computing and m-commerce. Okay, so let's start with this. So architecture is very basic, or you can say very easy. And here are the set of protocols that are used in, you can say, WAP, and here are the things they are based on. Okay, so wireless application environment makes use of HTML. Next is wireless session protocol and wireless transaction protocol. Each of the protocol I'll be explaining later on, you don't need to worry about that. It is based on HTTP. Next is wireless transaction layer security. It is based on TLS SSL. And next is wireless datagram protocol and user datagram protocol. So generally there is an option between the two. You can either use this one or this one, but generally wireless datagram protocol is preferred. And next one is wireless bearer, basically the kind of service like SMS, USS, CSD, GPRS, etc. Okay, so now let's start with each of the protocol. Before this, I'll be telling you that there are different modes, okay, on which the WAP architecture work or WAP architecture is based on. Okay, I'll be telling you each of the modes later on once I finish off this layer. Okay, so let's start with the first layer, that is wireless application environment. Okay, now what is this? From the name, okay, name only you can make out that it is the environment that is provided for you can say controlling an application wirelessly. So this acts as a glue between the mobile communication device as well as the internet, or you can say world wide web. Okay, so it joins the both. Okay, for example, you are using a mobile and there is a internet kind of thing. Okay, so what this does is this joins the both, or you can say this acts as an interface book for the both. Okay, so this is one of the main things. After this, and this makes use of HTML. okay, then next one is wireless session protocol. So from the name only you can make out that this provides a session between the mobile communication device and the internet. Okay, this maintains a particular session. Next is wireless transaction protocol. So this does not have much work. The work of this wireless transaction protocol is that if there are any lost packet which were not sent it, so the work of this layer, or you can say this protocol, is to send those lost packet again to the receiver. Okay, next one is wireless transaction layer security. This is from the name only can be count that it is done, or you can say its work is for encryption and decryption of data that is being sent it through WAP. Okay, next is wireless datagram protocol and user datagram protocol. So these are the protocols that are based on sending of datagram, or you can say sending of data over internet. And last one is wireless bearer, you know, kind of service the user is using, that is SMS, GPRS, CDMA, etc. Okay, so I guess you got the basic idea about this. Now let's discuss about the modes. Okay, the most important thing in WAP architecture. Okay, so there are mainly four modes. First is connection less mode. So what happens in connectionless mode is this layer, that is wireless session protocol, acts directly upon wireless datagram protocol. Okay, so because of this, what happens is transmission of data becomes very fast, very quick. But because of these two layer are being absent, and this layer being directly being used upon this layer, there are certain disadvantages. First disadvantage is this: because of the absence of this layer, no retransmission of lost packet or lost data packets is possible. And second thing is, because wireless transaction layer security is not there, so there is no encryption and decryption of data. Okay, the data is sent like this only. So this is the basic mode. Okay, next is connectionless mode with security. Okay, so this is the second kind of mode which is used by WAP. So in this, what we do is from the name only can make out that we try to provide the security to the data that is being sent online. So for this, what we do is we include this layer, that is wireless transaction layer security. And because this layer is included, the errors in data, or you can say when data is transmitted from sender to receiver, or you can say mobile to world wide web, and again from world wide web to mobile, the error can be verified, but error cannot be rectified, or you can say error cannot be retransferred. If there are any lost packet, that cannot be retransferred to the, you can say, receiver. So that is a problem, because wireless transaction protocol is still not used. Okay, so it helps in providing detecting errors, but you can't rectify those errors. Okay, next one is connection mode. So connection mode, you can say, is a better you can say protocol wise so because connection mode is a better mode wise so because this includes wireless transaction protocol. Okay, so what it does is, let's see. Okay, so in this, what are the three layers we have? Wireless session protocol and wireless transaction protocol, and with this we use wireless datagram protocol. Okay, we don't use wireless transaction layer security. That means we don't encrypt as well as decrypt data over here. Yeah, if there are any lost packet, or if there are any packets which were not sended, for those packets we can use wireless transition protocol, so that those packet can be resended to the receiver, okay, with the help of this layer. But there is no security to the data, or no encryption to the data. Okay, so only thing missing over here is the encryption and decryption of data. And last mode is connection mode with security. So in this, what we do is, we have all the four layers acting on or working on, that is wireless session protocol, wireless transaction protocol, wireless transaction layer security protocol, and user wireless datagram protocol. So because of this, you have the retransmission of data possible. You can detect error as well as retransmit data. You can check whether your data is safe or not, the integrity of the data, because of the encryption and decryption of data. And because you are using wireless datagram protocol, you can quickly transfer. Now, one point to be noted here, you will say that the connection mode with security is the best mode. It depends upon the situation. Okay, if your data is okay, you don't need a security, right? Then you can directly use connection layer mode, right? Why you will encrypt your data and you will waste time? Okay, so if you want quick transfer of data, you can directly use connection mode without security one. Okay, or you can use connection less mode without security one. So it depends upon the situation which mode you want to use, and accordingly you can send your data. So this was all about WAP architecture. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and if you have any doubt, do share in comments, and I will help you as soon as possible. So thanks for watching the video.